for great things, like democracy. Okay, now you can hear it better. Okay, excellent. Greek theater was born from the festivals that were held to honor the gods of? Yes, of wine.
Dionysos.
Excellent. And from the mystics for God, for honor, drama was born. Drama is a theatrical play that has three different kinds: tragedy, comedy, and yes, satires, we call it. Drama is the theatrical play. The kinds of drama are three, okay? And all of the dramas, all of the plays were held in the theaters, okay? Now, when the theater was born, there were not a lot of equipment, so they were really things, okay, but there were three main parts of the theater. It was the place that the audience were sitting, yes, and it was called the auditorium. In Greek, it is called kilon. It's something like circle because of its shape. You can all understand why it was called like that. In the middle of the theater, it was called Thymeli, where they had their sacrifices in order to honor their god, god Dionysus, where the dancers were sitting and singing. It was called orchestra. It was in front of the theater, between the auditorium and the scene. The scene in these years, backstage, where the actors changed their masks and their dresses. Okay? In front of the scene, it was a full scene where all the acting took place. Okay. Now, we call
chorus.
Okay? They were not acting, they were singing. Understood? Yes. And they were sitting where? At the
auditorium.
No, auditorium is not
here. The scene which is called? Pre-scene. And where were they changing their clothes and their masks? Scene. Excellent. Because we're going to have a test. That's why I'm asking you again and again. Somebody is cheating, I think. Wow. What about the actors that were taking part? There were only three. The first actor in Greece, the first who invented drama, was Thespis, was the one that had the idea to separate from the chorus and to answer back, not by singing, but with talking.